The low light and night video performance of the GoPro Hero 8 is actually much better than I expected. So in this video I will share my settings and give some tips to make sure you get the best results. If you're new to this channel, my name is Pascal and I teach you how to create professional videos with consumer cameras. So if that sounds interesting for you, make sure to subscribe. And let's talk about the GoPro Hero 8's video quality in low light conditions. I've been out yesterday and tested it a bit, and the results I got are definitely not the same as you would get with a full frame DSLR, for example, but they are absolutely usable. The only real downside that I experienced with this footage was that hypersmooth stabilization didn't work as good as under sunlight conditions, so that's a little bit of a bummer, but to be honest, if you only do slight movements with your hands, it's not a real issue. It becomes an issue, however, when you start walking, so in that case you want to use a gimbal. But even more important to get really good results in low light conditions with this camera is to use the right settings, and that's what I want to share with you now. So my settings start with 4K and 24 frames per second. The important thing here is that you use 24 FPS because when you have a lower FPS, you can also lower the shutter speed, and that allows for a brighter image, so more light hits the sensor, and that's very important for low light. So my recommendation is definitely 24. If you live in Europe, you can shoot in 25. It's up to you at the end. But if you live in the US, I would not recommend to shoot in 30 FPS. It already makes your image a bit darker, and yeah, that just sucks. Then the next setting is the lens. There I've set it to super view instead of wide, what I usually use, or native. The reason for that is simply that in super view it reads the whole sensor, and that is better because the less the camera crops in, the smaller the pixels are, and therefore you notice the noise less. So definitely use super view there. It's a little bit distorted, so you're a bit more limited by how you can shoot, but overall you get a better image quality. Hypersmooth, I've turned it to on. It's not perfect as mentioned before, but still better than nothing, no stabilization. And under ProTune, I've set my bitrate to high. I always have set it too high to make sure I can do more color grading. And then this is very important, the shutter. I've set the shutter to 1/48. That is because I want to have it twice the frame rate. So the frame rate is 24, the shutter has to be 48. You can set it lower, and you can also set it to automatic, but that would make your video look very weird because then you get too much motion blur. At 48, you get the perfect natural motion blur according to the 180 degree rule, but if you set it lower, then you get too much motion blur, and that looks very weird, as you can see here right now. So just set it twice your frame rate and you're good to go. White balance, I've set it to auto, what I usually don't do, but in low light conditions it just makes everything a lot easier. ISO min to 100 and ISO max at 800. There's just too much noise in 1600, so I wouldn't do that. If you don't know what ISO is, it basically means the sensitivity of the sensor. So the higher the sensitivity is, the brighter the image gets, but you also get more noise. Sharpness, I've set it to medium. It just gives a good look. It doesn't look too digital, but also not too soft, so that's great. And a very important setting here also is to set color to GoPro. Reason for that is that you want to have a contrasty image, and if you would set it to flat, then it would mean that it brightens up your shadows, and that introduces more noise into your image. So you don't want that, you just want to use the normal GoPro color profile. So from my testing, these are actually the best settings for shooting in low light conditions with the GoPro Hero 8. It's actually exactly the same with every camera. You always want to make sure that as much light as possible hits the sensor by keeping the shutter speed low, but not below twice the frame rate. And you also want to have a contrasty picture profile to hide the noise in the shadows. Aside from that, if you want to create more professional and cinematic videos with a GoPro camera in general, I've recently created a new online course, which is called the Cinematic GoPro Video Masterclass. And there I teach you really everything that you need to know for professional GoPro footage, starting from the accessories, going over shooting the actual videos and the final edit. So if that sounds interesting for you, you can check it out. I'll leave a link to that in the description below. And if you like this video, then please leave me a thumbs up, and also make sure to hit the subscribe and the bell notifications button for upcoming videos. And yeah, thanks for watching, and see you next week.